So next is Riemann theorem. So that is related to removal singularity. So what is the statement of this theorem? If z equal to z naught is a isolated singular point, so this is an isolated singular point of a function fz, and fz is bounded in some deleted neighborhood of z naught. Second is fz is bounded, then z naught will be removal singularity of fz. Mean, for a bounded function, the essential, the isolated singular point will be converted to removal singularity. So agar bahut simple bhasha ch gal kariye ta bounded function diyan isolated singular point removal singularities hondgiyan. Bounded function diyan isolated singular point removal singularities hondgiyan. Now in this theorem there are two given things. One is z equal to z naught is a isolated singular point, and second is function is bounded in the deleted neighborhood. Now suppose this is a deleted neighborhood of a function z naught. So this point is z naught and this point is z naught, and it is a circle with radius epsilon. So deleted neighborhood, let f of z is bounded, let f of z be a bounded in deleted neighborhood which is written as neighborhood of z naught, epsilon is radius, so it is a neighborhood, not deleted. It is a deleted neighborhood z such that 0 less than z minus z naught modulus less than epsilon. So this function fz is bounded in a deleted neighborhood whose radius is epsilon. So this is a neighborhood of z naught with radius epsilon, and in this point is excluded, so z naught is excluded. If it is a bounded, so I take maximum values, let we know that the maximum value of this function is on the boundary, so I take m which is a maximum of a function fz, this values, and this is on a boundary z minus z naught which is equal to epsilon. So this is by maximum modulus principle. So this is a m which is a maximum of this values. So by Laurent expansion, since z equal to z naught, the given is isolated singular point of function fz. So we can expand by Laurent expansion. So by Laurent expansion, this function can be written as f of z, which is equal to summation of an z minus z naught raised to power n, n is running from 0 to infinity, plus summation of bn over z minus z naught raised to power n n is running from 1 to infinity. So what is an, where an and bn is defined as, so this is a equation number 1, so where an, so which is equal to 1 by 2 pi iota, this is integration around c fz dz over z minus z naught raised to power n plus 1. C is the sum contour lie in the region, and bn is 1 by 2 pi iota around c f of z, so which is z minus z naught raised to power minus n plus 1. So basically it is a minus n, so just replaced n by negative minus of n. Now this bn, modulus of bn, this can be written as integration modulus of 1 by 2 pi iota integration c f of z into dz over z minus z naught raised to power minus n plus 1 and absolute value. Now this can be written as less than equal to modulus of this, which is a 1 by 2 pi. This is a integration around this, modulus of fz into modulus of dz over modulus of z minus z naught raised to power minus n plus 1. So this values. Now since it is a bounded function, so this value is less than equal to capital M. So this can be written as capital M over 2 pi integration C z minus z naught raised to power n minus 1 into modulus of dz. So this is taken at this place. So minus n is converted to plus n, and plus 1 is converted to minus 1. Now this modulus is less than epsilon. If it is a less than epsilon, so this can be written as less than equal to m epsilon raised to power n minus 1 over 2 pi, and this is integration around c, which is a modulus of dz. So what is this? This is a circumference of the circle. So this is 2 pi epsilon. So this can be written as m epsilon raised to power n minus 1 2 pi into 2 pi epsilon. So this value is equal to m epsilon raised to power n. So this values. Now this epsilon, as epsilon approaches to 0, so this approaches to 0 as epsilon approaches to 0. Since it is a some arbitrary numbers, so this value approaches to 0. So if this value approaches to 0, then modulus of bn is equal to 0 for every n. So it implies bn is equal to 0 for every n. If bn 0, then all the term of principal part is removed. So it implies f of z, which is equal to summation of a n z minus z naught raised to power n, where n is running from 0 to infinity. So it implies this z equal to z naught, this values. So what is it? It is a removal singularity, singular point of a function fz. So in this way we can prove that z is equal to z naught is the removal singularity of a function fz.